I would absolutely spend a draft pick on Lynn Bowden. Obviously, not a first round draft pick, but I'd probably spend a, I think you could probably get him in the third round, and I absolutely would spend that pick on him. I think he can be a great Taysom Hill type player. I'm not quite sure I would use him just as a wide receiver, and I probably wouldn't use him as an every down quarterback, but I do think that he can fill that Taysom Hill role that I think more and more teams will try to fill as we move ahead into future, where teams are more willing to try some more creative stuff. We've seen two teams do that, actually. We saw, obviously, the Saints of Taysom Hill. I think some people forget that Lamar Jackson was kind of the Ravens' Taysom Hill up until they then decided to get rid of Flacco and make Jackson their starting quarterback. I'm not quite sure I would say that Bowden is on a Jackson level, but I could see him being a Taysom Hill level. Absolutely, I could. So, like on this play, what's going to happen is that first things first, Bowden is going to basically just fake as though it's going to be a pitch to the top half of the screen, just a little quick fake there. Then he'll run out to the bottom half of the screen. And to help sell this fake a little bit, they're going to also have their offensive line start off as though they're blocking in that direction, but actually their right guard and right tackle are both going to pull around and then try to block those two Louisville players right there. It's a little bit of trickery trying to make sure that they get some Louisville players to move up to the top half of the screen. And as you see after the ball snapped, it kind of works, but there is one Louisville player who read this very well. It's realizing what's going on and is going to try to help make a play. He's in pretty good position at this point. Because of him, there are, now three defenders in the area, only two offensive linemen who can make a block. And so for Bowden, this could be a very bad situation. If someone is able to run over and make a tackle, they could end up not gaining any yards on this play. But really, watch how he's just going to be able to run faster than everybody. He runs to the outside and picks up a first down. Forget gaining yards. He was able to get a first down and then some. And that's what Bowden can bring to the table. He really is just such a physically talented player. He's just has that great combination of just speed and acceleration, but also he's just tough to bring down. He very much reminds me of Taysom Hill in that sense, where you look at Taysom Hill and he's just such a difficult guy to bring down. Bowden is very much of that way, and I think, honestly, I think Bowden accelerates quicker than Hill does, quite frankly. Like, this play will really show off his acceleration. What's going to happen is that, first things first, it's going to be a little bit of a delay, and so when the right guard and right tackle make their blocks, they are traditional blocks, but since it's a bit of a delay, it's going to be set up as though they're pass blocking, which will allow for a bigger gap for Bowden to potentially get through. Because then what Kentucky is going to do is have their center and their left guard both double team an interior lineman, but then also their center is going to move up to block that Virginia Tech player right over there. And again, because you have a quarterback who's going to run, this kind of gives you a little bit of an extra advantage because it gives you an extra blocker. So this way, their halfback can run out and block that Virginia Tech player, and essentially everybody is going to be accounted for. So Bowden can simply just run straight through, the entire gap, and hopefully he can get completely free. So after the ball is snapped, first part of the play works out pretty well. Bowden easily is able to get to the line of scrimmage. This part is great, but now there's the question of how much can he really get on this play. There are two Virginia Tech players who could potentially get off their blocks and try to make a play, but the problem with that is just look at how quickly he accelerates. I mean, he gets there so quickly he's able to showboat before he even gets into the end zone. That's just what he's bringing to the table. It's his quick acceleration. He's tough to bring down. He's just somebody that, quite frankly, I would not want to have to go against because he would be such a headache. Again, I'm not saying that you have to necessarily let him be your every down starter, but you know what? Use him as a Taysom Hill. Use him for certain snaps in certain situations. I don't think he's the natural thrower that like a Lamar Jackson or even a Taysom Hill honestly are, but you know what? I mean, you don't have to throw that well. If you can do that in the running game, you can just be solid in the passing game, and that's totally fine. You can just sort of keep the defense honest in a way, and that's all you really have to do. Again, nobody's gonna be drafting him to be a pocket passing quarterback. Definitely not. But like a play like this, for example, it's man coverage, and what Kentucky is going to do is they're going to start off as though they have their tight end running out to block that Virginia Tech player right over there. And so after the ball is snapped, it looks like that's what he's going to do. He's getting ready to block, and, I mean, it's so hard to get around some of these blockers that you really want to make sure you do get around quickly, especially with Bowden, who can run by you so quickly that if you just give him an inch, that's all he needs to get by you. So you have to try to get around your block very quickly. But the problem with that is that for Kentucky, this is actually not going to be a running play. Watch out, tight end quickly just slips by him, gets wide open. And Bowden, I mean, that's not an amazing throw by any means, but it doesn't have to be because his player got wide open just due to the situation and due to the threat of Bowden being able to run around people. That's what he does on basically every play. Yeah, you know, it's easy to throw it to a wide open guy, but he's going to have opportunities to throw it to wide open guys if he gets enough snaps because of the fact that he can do such a good job of running with the football. It's the same thing I said about Cam Newton. It's the same thing I said about Lamar Jackson. It's that, yeah, maybe these guys can't make the kind of throws that a Drew Brees can make. Granted, I'm not sure if anybody can make throws as accurately, as consistently as Drew Brees, but maybe they're not that kind of accurate, but they don't have to be because their running ability will make those windows bigger. You know, that's how Lamar Jackson is able to be so effective in the passing game and in the running game. Well, for Bowden, again, he's not going to throw the ball very often. I wouldn't have him throw the ball very often, but you can have him do it a time or two to really just keep the defense honest, and it'll work more often than not if you only do it on small occasions. And also, watching him when he played for Kentucky, he just had a few plays that were just absurd, just ridiculous plays that make you just go, okay, let's draft him because that's just stupidly good. Like this play, for example, it's going to be man coverage first and foremost because it's a third down and eight. It seems like it's going to be a typical passing situation, but of course, with Bowden, you usually don't want to pass the ball. And they're not going to pass the ball. First thing they do after the ball is snapped is that their left tackle moved further in, which basically made the edge rusher say, okay, I should try to get around to the edge. But because he's doing this, this now means that Bowden can run in between the guard and the tackle on the top half of the screen. Also, a little side note is that the right guard is losing his own one-on-one matchup pretty badly. That's not part of the play. That just happened to happen. But that's okay for Kentucky. Bowden can still run through the gap that he wants to run through, and that's what he's going to do. Granted, a bit more traffic has to run a little bit quicker, but he's totally capable of doing that. And now at this point, I mean, you look at his receiver. The one receiver that was on the top half of the screen can run out to block the defensive back in the area. There is a linebacker in the area who can potentially try to make this play, but at the same time, you know, it's going to be a tough angle, and he's going to have to run at least a little bit before he's able to knock Bowden out of bounds. Actually, I said that's a linebacker. That's actually a defensive lineman. But again, either way, eventually he'll be able to knock Bowden out of bounds, but at least Bowden should be able to pick up another 10 yards or so. However, Bowden's instead just able to accelerate and run by both of them. And now at this point, I mean, he's completely gotten by that defensive player. He's not going to make a play, basically, at this point. But there is now a defensive back in the area. He's running over. He's going to be the guy who tries to run over and just knock Bowden out of bounds. But then there's the other thing I love about Bowden, and it's going to be his footwork. Watch how, despite all of that, he's able to cut back to the inside, get around one tackle, and cut back to the inside again and get around another tackle and get into the end zone for a touchdown. I mean, again, it kind of stopped becoming a breakdown and started becoming a, oh my God, look at this. Oh my God, look at this. There were just so many impressive parts of that play. And that's just what he brings to the table for whatever team that he's going to get drafted by. He's just a freak athlete. And again, I bring up the Taysom Hill thing because I think they're such similar players. But quite frankly, I think there's a real chance that Bowden could play the Taysom Hill role better than Taysom Hill could. Maybe I'm getting a bit ahead of myself. He hasn't played a snap in the NFL yet, so we'll have to wait and see. But I really like this guy, and I really think that he can be great in a style of system like that if he gets used properly. And one other thing that I think matters about him is the fact that since he, you know, is very much a wide receiver, he might get drafted as a wide receiver, I think that that can actually help him in a lot of ways. Like, on this play, it's going to be a quick play action. That's going to hopefully get that Florida player to move in. And then what they can do is it'll be Bowden, who's actually lined up as a receiver right now. He's going to run that route right there. Just a quick curl route. His job is to accelerate quickly, try to gain a few yards down the field. You know, the Florida player will be out of the area, so accelerate quickly, but then stop quickly and turn around and be able to make the catch. That's what Bowden's job is on this play. And he does it very well. Watch how quickly, after the ball is snapped, he very quickly is able to get over, get in position, and now his quarterback is going to throw the ball to him. it was a good well-ran route. And also, after he makes the catch, he's able to make a couple of moves and gain some more yards, which, you know, that's the other factor of him as a receiver, is that he's a guy who you're afraid of once he gets the ball in his hands, absolutely. But the real reason I believe that that matters is because now if you do that, if you're a team who has him as a receiver, maybe he's your third receiver or even fourth receiver, you can have him get a good amount of snaps in that way, preferably with a third receiver, obviously, because then what you can do is you can do what the Saints do, where they'll have Taysom Hill line up as a receiver, but then what they'll do is they'll have Taysom Hill line up as quarterback and Breeze line up as a receiver, and then the opposing team can't substitute because you don't have to give up time for them to substitute since you didn't substitute any of your own players. So let's just say the Jets decide to select Bowden, then they can have Bowden be a receiver. He's a more than capable receiver to get some solid playing time. But then what he can do is then he can just run over to the quarterback position. Sam Darnold lines up towards the sideline. Somebody has to cover him because he still can't catch. And now if your opposing defense is in like a dime package, for example, well, now they're stuck with that. Now they're stuck with that many defensive backs out there, or just a package that they maybe don't want out there. So yeah, that's what I like about him. It's his acceleration mixed with his ability to just, you know, he's really tough to bring down. On top of that, I just think that he's just a tremendously talented athlete, and sometimes you just gotta draft a tremendously talented athlete. I think you could probably get him easily in the late second. I think you could probably get him in the third round, which is just great value, in my opinion, for a pick like that. I think that's one of the things that, you know, people have been saying, are we going to see every team try to have a Lamar Jackson type style offense? And the obvious counter to that is, well, no, because not every team has a Lamar Jackson. You have to have the player first if you are going to run those types of plays. Well, Bowden is a type of player who can run those types of plays. Again, will he be there for every snap? I just don't know. But absolutely, he's somebody I want on my team, and I'd totally be willing to spend a mid-round pick on a guy like that. Absolutely. A day two pick, to me, that's a no-brainer. Again, we'll have to see if a team uses him properly as well. I'm so worried that he's going to end up getting drafted by some boring team that just uses him as a receiver, and we never get to see him line up under center. But I would love to see him get to have a chance to be a team's Taysom Hill. I think it makes a lot of sense. But yeah, that's just my opinion. What do you guys think about Bowden? Let me know in the comments below. Always love hearing from you. And of course, as always, thanks for watching.